Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. This is Force with some more Elder Scrolls Online. In today's video, I will be taking you through the public group dungeon, the Village of the Lost. This is the public dungeon for Cold Harbor. Each one of the zones has a single public group dungeon and a bunch of public solo dungeons. The public group dungeon's tailored for 2 to 3 people, usually, or one person who's really good at AoE, and that'll be me here today. I haven't done this yet. When I went through this zone first on my Khajiit Nightblade, when I was leveling him up, I actually just had basically out-leveled this dungeon, so I decided not to do it. But the second time around, I'd like to show you this, and I'd like to experience it for myself. So let's go ahead and see what this place is all about.
You're alive. Just what I need.
Who are you?
I'm Saroni, mayor of Silver Run, a small township in Vardenfell. Morlarg Bal's servants tried to pull Silver Run into Cold Harbor. And now I'm stuck here. Two other towns founded by Khajiit and Orcs were taken as well.
Perhaps I can help.
You are most gracious. I would be grateful. You could rescue the Orcish and Khajiiti leaders. They're all that's left of their villages. Tell them I have what we need to escape. They'll understand.
Sounds good.
You'll find Ugors in the Orc stronghold to the east, and Zurani in the Khajiit village in the west. Both were once flourishing townships, but no longer. They'll need help to escape. I'll meet you all at the Overseer's Overlook.
Okay, alright, so it looks like I have to save two towns that have been sucked here into Cold Harbor. And it's kind of crazy. It's actually funny, because that's what the Dark Anchors are all about, too. Morlarg Bal trying to pulled parts of Tamriel into Cold Harbor, and it looks like he succeeded in some of these. Alright, already picking up blues. So yeah, these are tailored for 2 to 3 people. I also want to make that clear distinction. You know, when you hear dungeons, usually, and I think this might have been a little bit of a mistake on, oh gosh, this isn't good. Second group just got pulled in. Alright, I think this might have been a little bit of a mistake on ZeniMax's part. Basically, them referring to these things as dungeons, I think, is really going to confuse people. But not, you know, you could say, oh, look, who are these idiots? No, it's more that typically when someone hears dungeons, wow, I'm picking up a lot of gear. What the heck? What is going on? I've got an epic already. By the way, the on the bottom right, you're seeing all that loot pop up. That's an add-on. I'll give you a link to the add-on in the description below. I am picking up all this sweet loot. Oh, nice. That is a pretty significant upgrade to the one that I had. And what about these britches? That's stamina over magicka. Do I have a stamina enchant for it? No, that's too bad. If I can re-enchant that to magicka, that would actually be really good too. And that's actually 91 damage. That's an upgrade too. This is pretty hilarious. In the first few seconds of this run, I've already picked up quite a few upgrades. I think this might confuse some people from the outside looking in. And what I mean by that is usually when you hear dungeon, you think, all right, so we've got some elite trash mobs, and then we've got a bunch of elite trash mobs, and then we've got a bunch of bosses. We go in there with a group, we pick up loot. And these aren't, they sort of are that, but they aren't at the same time, because these are sort of meant as side excursions, and there are the real dungeons, the group instance dungeons in the game, which is what you traditionally think of in an MMO when you hear dungeon. But I think calling these side excursion dungeons the same thing, instead of calling them, like, explorable areas, or I don't know, there's all sorts of different, you know, terminology they could have used. I just think it might cause some confusion from people on the outside looking in, but that's why at the start of these videos, I always try to make that distinction pretty clear. Alright, who is this?
Praise Maridia. This one was worried he'd never find another living soul in this horrible place.
But who are you?
I am Mezzadror, follower of Maridia. Cold Harbor has been merging with choice regions of Tamriel, and this border realm alone has taken 3 villages, absorbed them through tears in space. My lady tasked me to hinder this. It's been difficult.
I'll help.
Help? Yes. There are 3 tears. Holes in the world where Tamriel is falling into oblivion. There's a tear in each village.
Alright, I'll hold off the Dremora. You'll help with the tear. That sounds great. Alright, where am I supposed to go here? Do I just really drop down here? Like I said, I haven't been through... haven't been through these dungeons yet, so... or this particular one. I really do like the aesthetic of Cold Harbor. I like the way the water looks, or whatever this goo stuff is supposed to be. It's got a sort of a cool luminescent quality to it when you pass through it. I like what they did with the design of Cold Harbor. I think they did a good job. Looks good. I won't be showing you all of it, you know, but obviously you're seeing a little bit of it here. Oh, this was just a little side area. Always check cupboards and nightstands and things like that, because they can carry those racial motifs, which is what you use to craft the different racial styles. That's where you'll find those. You won't find them in the typical crates and barrels. Crates and barrels and all of that will only contain provisioning material. So that's only if you're interested in the food crafting part of this game. Just a small group here. So yeah, I drop down the flame, I root them all in place, and then I do a few more AoE attacks. I'll do my AoE heal. Oh my gosh. I'll do my AoE heal if necessary. So there's a little bit of latency with this combat sometimes, which is very frustrating. Like the weapon swapping, I tried to weapon swap there a moment ago in combat when I was running away from those guys. I wanted to weapon swap so I could heal up. And there was a good like couple of second wait, and it wasn't like a GCD sort of wait, because you can attack and then weapon swap very quickly, but sometimes it just won't respond quickly. Now maybe we could attribute that to, you know, latency on my side, like my personal internet connection. Maybe that's the explanation for it, but it's very frustrating when it happens, because I've played other MMOs that I feel are a little bit more responsive in the combat territory. Most of the time. That's probably my biggest complaint about the combat with this game. Like, the overall design of the system I think is fine. I think it works well, it's functional, it's a little bit of a balance between the standard tab target system and a more action-focused combat. It's a meshing of those two. This game does a lot of meshing, sort of like how it meshes traditional Elder Scrolls games with... meshing a traditional Elder Scrolls style game with an MMO, and the combat is also a meshing, again, of action combat and tab targeting with that soft lock system. But when it doesn't respond how it should, it can be very, very frustrating, especially in situations like these. Now, you've been seeing me clear through these mobs, but believe it or not, this is a very precarious situation, because if I mess up even for a slight moment, then that's it. Like, I'm done for. These guys will kill me very, very quickly if I let them get within melee range for even just a second. There's actually a couple small packs down there. I'm gonna try something that is a little bit risky. Look at this, see, look at that. That was a group of three, right? And they got me down to half health when I set in there for even just a second. So again, just shows you, it can get a little scary. All right, so I'm gonna try something here. This might be suicide, but I think I might be able to pull it off. There you go, I was. It's crazy. I wonder, what I'm thinking is, this build is so strong, maybe this is gonna make them consider putting caps on AoE damage, because I kill a group of characters just as fast as I kill a single person. It's kinda crazy.
Keep watch while I close this.
All right, closing the tear. See what's in this heavy crate here. Usually some sort of... Oh crap, that's a single boss. Oh my god. I'm actually gonna do a quick... Okay, she hasn't aggroed me yet. I'm gonna do a quick switch here. Single bosses, I don't want the inhale so much. Having the fiery clench is really pretty good though. Her so that, yeah, that's exactly what I want. So I'm just gonna keep her knocked back, although I should have let her sit in my damage for longer. But and then we can also get some stuns from my charge attack there, so we should be okay. Yeah, this is crazy. So much health compared to. So yeah, this is a little single mini boss. And these you will periodically come across in these dungeons. Follow that up with a charge attack. And I completely lost sight of her there. That's really crappy. And then we knock her off balance, which means another heavy attack will drop her down like that. So it just takes a little bit more persistence. Okay. What the hell? And we should be just about all set. There we go. And I guess like nothing, no loot off of that.
Our deal is good then, yes?
Yes, the village will be ours and you shall have your gold.
Excellent. Now how do I get out of here?
That was not part of our deal. Enjoy your gold.
Did you hear that? That Khajiit doomed her own village. She's the reason it is here.
Do hope for multiple, although sometimes these single characters can't be CC'd. He's not. He's not an exception to that rule, apparently. There we go. Ooh, someone rooted me in place. That's cute. I still can't believe that we picked up all that awesome loot at the start of this run. Frankly, that's a little bonkers to me. So doing a different ultimate right now. This one caps all incoming damage at 3% of my health, which is really, really nice. It also does a little bit of AoE damage, just not a ton, but it's something. Now, clearly, as you can see, taking out that pack didn't go as quickly as it does when I drop the dragon standard ultimate, but just wanted to try that. It makes you crazy tanky. Again, caps all incoming damage at 3% of your health. It's nothing else to say about it. That's nuts. That's really good. Into the Khajiit Town Hall. Wonder if there might could potentially be a maintenance.
It's time for your beatings.
Uh-oh.
Taskmaster is angry. Taskmaster hates this Khajiit. But Taskmaster hates this Khajiit talking to others even more. Go away, or this one will suffer.
Sarani sent me. She has what she needs to get you out of here.
This one cannot leave. On threat of endless death from Taskmaster upstairs. You are mad to come here. They have not taken you. You should flee while you can.
All right. I guess it's time to go kill the Taskmaster. Switch back to our single target. Able stun. It's nice. It's really nice to have those two stuns when you're fighting a boss. So the inhale isn't as important. I've got the... Because inhale is good when you've got a lot of enemies you're up against. Oh, this is a caster. I'm going to need to get up in his face. And just try to damage him as quickly as possible. With a stun back here. Actually, the further away I am, the better the stun is. So I'm going to run back and then go. It makes for a longer duration stun. And there you go. Taskmaster's dead. Awesome. Yeah, you gotta zerg down those casters because they will do a ton of damage to you. It's so much easier to CC, crowd control, knockdown, stun, all that stuff. It's so much easier to CC the melee mini boss characters, but those guys, you gotta be real careful.
You've returned, and this one heard the fighting. Could Taskmaster be dead?
Yes, Taskmaster is dead.
That is surprising.
All right, so Khajiit Town is saved. Now we go save the Orc Town. I can't believe this. Oh god, we picked up that staff is so awesome. Right at the start too. That's nuts to me. All right. Oh crap. That got scary. That could have been scary there for a second. All right, this will be a piece of cake. You know what's funny though? I'm gonna say that, and then one of these times, one of these groups is just gonna blow me up. Now when I drop down my ultimate, you'll notice I'm not doing much else. There's a reason for that. I'm just trying to not blow through. I basically just block after I drop down my ultimate standard because I'm trying to not blow through my Magicka. This is what's allowing me to continuously take out these huge packs without having to rest for anything, so. I don't know if I already said this in this video, but I'm going 5 light, 2 heavy. The 5 light gives me the Magicka, also gives me the increased crit for my spells. And the 2 heavy just makes me a little bit more tanky, whereas I otherwise wouldn't be. Try to interact with this thing. Sometimes it does not play ball. Well, a lot of times in these situations, if you've got a little bit of a bugged quest, you'll re-log, but I'm not going to do that here. We're just going to keep on going. And even though we're low, quick replenish, drop the ultimate. Dropping the ultimate also heals me up. Which further makes this build kind of seem a little ridiculous. Alright, let's drop down. That looked like a boss, is it? Yes, it is. Alright, I'm gonna find out right now if we're gonna be able to do this, ultimate or not. Yes, we are all set. Okay. It's always the big question with these things. If I can see it, we're good. If not, it's a little bit more of a problem. He's off balance, so another hit will knock him down like that. So how do I know that he's off balance? It's basically an ability of mine to pull him off balance like that, so. And then we're gonna go with another stun. Knock him off balance again. Oh no, never mind. Just finish him off here. There we go, there we go. Alright, mini boss taken care of. A chest, thank you. Chests look different, by the way, depending on the zone that you're in, so keep that in mind. Sometimes you'll have odd looking chests and you may pass it over because you think it's just a trunk or something. It's always worth, especially your first time traveling into a new area, it's always worth investigating those things that aren't obviously a crate or a trunk or something. So, question for you guys who are still here, hanging out, watching some gameplay in this video. What do you think you're gonna play at launch? I'd love to know. I'd love to do like a straw poll even. Maybe I'll do that. Maybe we'll set up a straw poll and you guys can tell me what you plan to play at launch. Because I would love to know what people's intentions are now that we're just really a few days away from that early access start. If you're not picking up early access, you'll have another 5 days to wait, but still. Actually, this was stupid. I should have waited till I replenished my mana. This is like a battle mage style. Oh, he's got pets too? Well, that sucks, actually. Alright. Let's try to avoid that. I'm gonna stay back so I can knock her into it. And then we're just gonna do a charge. Keep her in the fire. And that is that. Yeah, let me know what class you guys are gonna build. I'm still sort of in the air between. Oh no. I'm actually gonna die. God. After all this time. After all that time, we end up eating the dust right at the very end. Well, maybe it was for the better that we died, because on the way back, I actually found that this guy's available now. So we're actually able to complete this quest. So fantastic. I am glad that we died. No, not really. Kind of depressing. But anyways, we're able to complete this quest now. So that is something good that came of it all. So now let's blow this guy up, huh? All right, I'm going to knock him back in. Try to keep him low and stunned in this area. And let me go back, stun him again, and now we're just gonna have to focus on locking him down because it's quite clear that he can do a lot of damage if he hits me even a little bit, so. Go back. Big old heavy attack. Go like that. He gets up, we switch, do a charge. Knock him off balance, knock him down again. Go back, do another, oh, we're out of mana, there we go. We're out of stamina, do another charge. He gets up, do a knockback. And that is that.
It is done. Soon, your father will be dead.
Then at last, I will lead.
You will indeed rule at last, when the rock slide swallows the entire stronghold.
That orc
must have made a deal with that Dremora lord.
Alright, let's go in and see what's going on in the Orc Longhouse.
Please go away. If the Taskmaster knows we've talked, he'll be furious.
I was sent here. I could intimidate, but I was sent here to get you out of here.
Tempting, if I were an idiot. The Overseer stationed a Taskmaster here to keep me in line, and Cerrone wants me to risk his wrath?
I'll kill a Taskmaster. I've done it before. No problemo. Okay, Taskmaster. Task in your mass. What? Excuse me? What'd you call me? And I'll just... Oh, crap. I was hoping to switch to a charge. Freaking unresponsive controls did... Unresponsive controls at it again. I thought I hit the button for switch. It just didn't happen. Gotta love it, man. Gotta love it. Or not. Push some heavy damage here. Well, I should be careful. And again. As we wait for our Magicka to replenish, I'm gonna go with a heavy charge. Knock her back. And that's pretty much, we have her within death range now, so. Got a little low there for a second. It was a little scary, but not too bad. Well, what the hell? Supposed to stun from the charge attack that I did. Maybe because she was already stunned? I don't know. But this is actually a little scary. It's basically one more hit and I'm done for. How is she getting that hit off? Oh, God. Well, at least we took care of business. Alright, he's dead. You're dead. She's dead. You can leave.
I already told you. I have no wish to suffer
dead.
That you killed her?
Yes.
Incredible.
I know, it's incredible. Alright, time to go to the Overseer's Outlook. So we've saved both the villages. Saving both the villages, head down to the Overlook. I don't even know. I'm guessing there's some major... Oh, that's probably the Overseer, because the Overseer is the one who sent those Taskmasters. Hey, another epic. This one, a Hickory Bow. If only I were a ranger. So before we head to Overseer's Outlook, it looks like we've got a little side alcove area over here. So let's just clear a few packs and head on over in this direction. I'm assuming because this little side alcove isn't related to the quest that a lot of times when you see stuff like this, it will in fact be a, like a mini boss or something along those lines. So let's hope so. Ooh, it's a Sky Shard, even better. Almost just ignore these guys. It's how powerful that standard is. Maybe that's what we'll get tuned down. I would not be surprised if they do something about this build. It just seems a little bit stronger than it should be. Or maybe just... Well, I suppose because the last character that I leveled up, which was that Khajiit Nightblade, you know, he's more built for single target damage anyways, but... Just the ease of which I blow up the multi-targets seems like it just seems that it shouldn't be this easy to kill 5+ enemies at once. You know, you've seen in this run, it's not like I'm invincible. Like, death does occur, but... And speaking of which... I just almost died there. Able to pull it out at the last second, but... With a heal plus the ultimate healing me up. I just assumed there was something over here. Yeah, another boss, alright. I'll try that out. Let's give him a shot. Ulzor. Alright, so learning experience. Can we control him? No. Okay. So, that's... I'm just gonna revive on spot. He can't be CC'd. He did not get... he was not affected by that root in place, so... I am not gonna try him. We're just gonna move on. Oh, no. I don't have any repair kits. Oh, that's no bueno. If you're gonna go dungeon diving like this... probably bring some repair kits. There you go. Quick little lesson for you. Learn from my mistakes. Become a better person. Oh my god. Speaking of mistakes. And we're full inventory. Oh, this is just a hot mess. Full inventory, broken equipment. This is one hot mess. All right, let's go through anyways. Here it is, the final countdown. Did we save everyone? Is everyone happy?
Almost free. Only one task remains.
What's that?
You must die.
Oh, crap. Well, before we finish that conversation, let me set up my skills. Knowing that she wants to kill me now, let me set my skills up. Oh, that's so immersion breaking. All right, let's do that again.
We're almost free. Only one task remains.
You must not have seen what I did to the Daedra.
At ease. I'm fully aware of what you can do. That's why I'm not telling. I'm asking.
What?
Let me explain at least. I've secured a spell to get us out of this plane. However, in order to channel it, I require a sacrifice.
Any other options?
Time works differently in Daedric lands. I feel like I've searched for years and found nothing. You're the only plan I've got.
I guess I could.
Thank you. Your offer means more to me than you can know. The quickest, most painless way is right in front of you.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do that.
I hoped it wouldn't come to this. I'm afraid you won't have much choice in the matter.
Oh my god, there's three of them. Alright, I have got a feeling that there's nothing I can do about this. There's three elite characters at the end of this dungeon. You know, we were able to solo a good chunk of this thing, but
I thank you for your sacrifice. It has, friend, it has. You've given me and the
others
a chance to bring our story to
town. I guess that counted as the story. Okay. Whatever. okay, so I just needed to yeah, I see. I didn't even, okay. Well, I guess if you get a full group, you could probably clear that thing, and that would be all fine and dandy. But there you go, guys. That is a run through the Village of the Lost, the public dungeon in Cold Harbor. That's really funny that that ended up ending the way that it did. That's really rather comical. I need to go to town. I need to repair. We're gonna wrap up this video. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed some gameplay taking a look at the public dungeon here, the public group dungeon here in Cold Harbor. It was fun. Wasn't able to do everything, but still did a fair amount, and yeah, rather successful run. Thanks guys so much for watching. Stay tuned for more Elder Scrolls Online coverage coming up. Keep watching and keep owning.